We as a 3-member team have come to Odisha. The direction given to us is to visit the family of the victim and to interact with the people of that area and to submit a report to him. Since yesterday morning, we are interacting with the local people, public representatives, police officials, and we have visited the family of the victim. It is such a brutal murder. A girl who is hailing from an ordinary weaver's family. After her education, for her earning, she had joined in a school. The school is being taken care by the accused of the present criminal case, Govind Sahu. Not on the political angle. Just we would like to tell you about the doubts or the suspicion of any common man they have. The constancy being represented by the present MOS home, Mr. Dibyashankar Mishra. The accused of the present criminal case, Govind Sahu, is known a close aide of the Home Minister. And he is not only the close aide, and he is being seen as the representative of the Home Minister in that region. Often they were travelled together. Often the Home Minister, he had visited that school. Even the financial assistance from the MLA fund is being given to that school. We have got some information. And the accused of the present criminal case, who has visited Chief Minister's residence along with the Home Minister several times. It is all in the public domain. Initially, when the girl's parents, they have approached the police station to lodge an FIR, they have been dragged by the police department. And after investigation, Govind Sahu was interrogated for 3 days. But surprisingly, an unscheduled power cut has happened in the police station. He escaped. Then after that, the police has secured him. And now the DIG has given a press statement saying that it is some kind of a personal thing. And Govind Sahu has confessed that the victim has threatened him of exposing some kind of a relationships. Yesterday we also met the superintendent of police, Balangir. Our team and other local public representatives, we have met him. We have raised our doubts. Yes, of course, for some questions he has answered. He was telling that some of the body parts were handed over to the family of the victim and some objects have also been given back. We were asking him about the forensic report that is still pending. Media friends, I would like to tell you, investigation officer is under the Home Department. The constituency where the crime has occurred, it comes under the Home Minister. The accused is not an ordinary citizen of that particular assembly constituency. He is being seen as the representative of the Home Minister. Everything comes under the Home Ministry. Now, taking the confession statement and conducting the trial is another step in getting the justice. But conducting the trial also involves the Home Ministry. The police department has to conduct a free and fair investigation. And another important thing, that trial has to take place. When everything is to happen under the Home Ministry, it is not only the political parties, community organization, general people, they are telling that there is some big hand in this present criminal case. And in that situation, BJP Odisha unit is making a demand of removal of the Home Minister from the ministry. Repeatedly, they were demanding the state president, member of parliament, and our state office bearers. And series of agitations were being taken place in Odisha in the past 10 days. Even today, on behalf of Mahila Morcha, in every district, under the guidance of our state Mahila Morcha president, Srimati Smriti Patnaik, they are conducting agitations. This is being the situation. We feel that on the basis of the moral responsibility and also on the basis of the suspicion and the doubts, the Home Minister must step down. After a long time, yesterday evening he has given a press statement in the name of Goddess Manikeshwari. In the name of Lord Manikeshwari, in the name of Lord Jagannath, we are also demanding, we are also requesting the Home Minister to step down from the ministry for the sake of free and fair investigation and trial. As far as the other aspect of this incident, our team members, they would address about the issue. See, whatever that is available in the public domain, we are on that. How separately or parallelly we can conduct an investigation, that is not our job. But we are reflecting the doubts or the suspicion among the minds of the people. You need not compare with this. That is a state unit, already independently they have visited the place, they have made their demand. This is the central team. It is on two angles you could see that the central team is very much concerned about the safety and security of women. And our national president, through this delegation, has expressed his condolence to the family at the same time to assist the state unit. So whatever the report they have collected, whatever the demand they have raised, we are going to give it to the national president. You just imagine, sir, in that remote village, from an ordinary poor family, from that weaving community, whether that parents, they could understand this kind of a complicity of the case. Yes, of course. For their background, if anybody could imagine, they come out openly and saying that, yes, my daughter was having the laptop, my daughter was having the cell phones, and some of the communications were there. How we can expect? Who has pressurized? Minister. We don't know. It is for the investigation to tell that. That's why we are requesting. The minister should not be their boss. How an ordinary officer can interrogate the minister?